Welkom bij Introduction Masterclasses Cool Hunting by Signs of the Time, part 2. In part 1, we also talked about future core forecasting, and we told that the world has become flat, so everybody can compete who has a good idea and a good internet connection. How to win by be more creative, by be more innovative. And our claim was totally for sure, cool hunting helps. What does it look like? What does it look like to be the most innovative and the most creative? These are the key skills of the 21st century. Well, this is it. Steve Jobs always said the Chinese can make it, but we are the creative geniuses. And creativity and innovation, that's what counts. This is a Western hero, but this is the Eastern hero. Alibaba, Jack Ma. Chinese brains are as good as American ones, which is why we compete. This is the flat world in action. Everybody who's creative and innovative can win. This is Volkswagen with a concept for a solar panel fueled holiday camper. Totally creative. But these are the Chinese with a 3D printed customized astronaut seat for their astronauts. So creativity and innovation work in a flat world everywhere. This was a pick, the only pick I made myself. Biodegradable tin can. I don't know if the claim is correct, but it came from China. And this is what it was looking like in the shop window. And this is now the American version. Creativity and innovation are in a flat world worldwide. And as I told you, cool hunting helps. This is what we're promising. We will open your imagination further than you can do on your own. And we help you to explore your creative powers, collaborating with other cool hunters better than you can do on your own. A great example are these bananas. The Western, 30 years ago, the Western world was more creative than the Eastern world, Korea. But then Samsung understood, because they became stronger in technology, became stronger in creating mobile phones, we must aspire to become as creative as the West. So they hired one of the best designers from the West, and he had to teach the Korean designers from Samsung to become more creative. And he said, I give you an assignment, make a mobile phone that is as good as a banana, which means very distinctive color, highly sustainable. Everybody, if you throw it away, the banana totally goes. The outside tells you what the inside is doing. When the banana gets rotten, you can see it on the outside. These are the key characteristics of the banana, and I want you to design a mobile phone as is with these banana qualities. And the Eastern designers didn't understand. They really asked, do you want us to make a banana that look, do you want to make us a mobile phone that looks like a banana? So this is how much the Eastern designers could learn from the West 30 years ago, because now they're hugely creative. When you do cool hunt, we also do a lot of exercises to make you more creative. This is a fun place. The worst theme for a pinball machine, and here you have some fun answers. These kind of exercises we do to make you more creative. A double rainbow doesn't have gold at the end. Dat weten we. Instead, it has, and then you come up with your creative quote. It's fun. Cool hunting helps. Why? Well, it explores your creativity. You can standing on the shoulder of the whole cool hunting group, but it also increases your forecasting skills, of course. Cool hunting means you're going to hunt for cool seeds of new developments. If you do that together, if you blog about it in together, and you can read each other, you can improve each other, you can comment each other, you can rate each other, hello, then you become a better professional, then you have an increasing skill to forecasting the future. Well, here you have it. Cool hunting is increasing your trends and innovation sensitivity. We work very, very systematic on that. Another thing is, if you've done the cool hunting masterclasses, you really can say hello, I'm better in forecasting the future. Not only because I'm more creative, but in the least as important, I've worked with a lot of other cool hunters. I've read their material. I've been in the workspace where they've all blogged about the results of their cool hunts. And that works. So you can say hello, I'm standing on the shoulder of a fantastic group of people. Hire me. Last but not least, cool hunting is also about detecting early warning signs. And it's pretty important. I'll give you two examples. 10 years ago, and I gave you an example of 10 years ago because more recent examples, these are for the companies. 10 years ago, one of the cool hunters in a hospitality hunt said, wow, I found something great. It's a tiny seat, it's not big at all. It's not a website, it's a kind of platform. A platform was a new term then. And the idea is that all big hotel chains on this exclusive place offer all their hotel rooms. So a customer or a potential guest can select from all hotel rooms in the city offered by all the big hotel chains, what hotel room he, she prefers. And the other cool hunter said, okay, I like this a lot. Cool, 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 high ratings. So I presented that to a big hotel chain and they were totally against it. All the hotel chains are a bit stuck in the 20th century, slightly arrogant because they are so successful. And they all said, I'm not going to put my beautiful, fantastic hotels next to the competition. Next to the competition.
Connect. Dus je doet even een slide van tevoren even. En dan kun je weer weg. Dan ga ik switchen. Volgens mij was je bij die dame geweest.
Ja. Volgens mij weet je zeker of denk je het?
Doe maar deze opnieuw.
So another promise of cool hunting, it's increasing your trends and innovation sensitivity. We make that clear already. A pretty important one is also, it's increasing, ook ga terug. A pretty important one is also, you become more relevant for the companies you work for or you want to work for. Because cool hunting, you never do on your own. You do it with a group of cool hunting colleagues. They all hunting for cool seeds of new developments. They blog about it in protected workspaces for you and the group. It's called FUBU, for you, by you. So you learn a lot from your colleagues. So if you want to have another job, you don't only legitimately can say, hello, I can forecast the future. You can also say, hello, I'm standing on the shoulder of great other cool hunters. This workspace is my workspace. And that works. So it's a competitive edge when you want to compete for your next job, basically. Last but not least, cool hunting is also about detecting early warning systems or early warning systems. Cool hunting is also about detecting early warning signals before the rest. I give you two examples. 10 years ago, and this is an old example, but it's still pulsating with power today. 10 years ago, one of my cool hunters said, I found a place, it's a tiny place, it's not a website, it's a kind of platform in which, with the idea that all big hotel chains offer their hotel rooms on this place, all together. And so it's easy for a potential guest to select their favorite hotel room. And all the other cool hunters said, cool, 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 very high rating. So this was an idea, pulsating with coolness, pulsating with future growth potential. So I worked then for, I consulted a big hotel chain and said, look, this is happening. This is what young people today think cool. And the hotel chain, very successful and therefore stuck into the 20th century, he said, no, we're not going to do that. Our hotel rooms are so fantastic. We're not going to offer that next to the competition. Well, that place was called Booking.com. And now all hotel rooms from all the big chains pay 10, 15, 20% commission to Booking.com. That's the power of early warning signal. Somewhat later, one of the students from the cool food hunt said, oh, look, in America, they are really, really serious in producing plant-based meat. Not meat from cows, but from plants. And that went pretty quickly because this is only 5 years ago. Everybody liked it. And now this is on my mayonnaise, on my own table. But also then 5 years ago, it was an early warning signal. And now it's there. Sometimes it goes quick. We work with a lot of universities. Here you have a lot of them. And the interesting thing what we're doing now with this kind of introductions, we still want to work with universities. They're fantastic, but we want to do it on our own. So if as a potential cool hunt, if you like it, you can subscribe on an international cool hunt with all subscribers, but not related to a university anymore. Of course, the results from a cool hunt, and we do this already for 25 years, we present from time to time to the big companies, and the same trends you will learn from as well. How does it work? First, the definition. If you're going to hunt for tiny seeds of new developments that are cool, cool is attractive and inspiring with future growth potential. You're going to write blogs on hidden workspaces. Together with a whole group, together with a whole cool hunting group, and depending on the subject and depending on what nationalities will join, it can be pretty interesting and is always a great learning experience because, well, here you have the promises, makes you more creative and more innovative. You're standing on the shoulder of a whole group. Your forecasting skills will enhance, and probably you see some early warning signals as well. So this is how it works. The best is in a protected workspace, so only for you, for you, by you. But the best, if you want, we give some worldwide publicity at Futurist Club by Science of the Time. Some pics from all over the world. This is Brazil. It was very hot in Sao Paulo, so we immediately went cool hunting on the internet. Very hardworking, lovely, expressive students. And this is India. Same questions, same cool hunt assignments, totally different atmosphere. Moscow, I love this guy because this guy loved the project. We've worked with him for several times. Vietnam, here you see very tiny, cool is attractive and inspiring with future growth potential because you must know the definition. This is cool hunting in Ho Chi Minh City. This is Milano Fashion Institute. This is Helsinki, this is Stockholm, this is Helsinki, sorry, with some of the cool hunters. This is Peru on a cool luxury hunt and a cool hospitality hunt. This is Barcelona, where I'm a professor right now. Here we go from the hotel school to the city. This is 2 years ago, this is 1 year ago. This is Universitat Católica, a cool luxury hunt, a cool fashion hunt into the cities. This is Roberta Crespi, one of my favorite professors in the world. A cool hunt in London. A cool hunt in Cairo. This is American University Cairo. Ibero-Americana is the same in New Mexico City. And then, of course, every year, a cool hunt in maybe sometimes twice, even thrice, in Shanghai, in China. The nice thing with Chinese, if you make a pic, they do like this. So I said to my Dutch students, hello, greet my Chinese students. And this is what it looks like. If we're going to hunt for boutique hotels, we visit a lot of boutique hotels and also retail concepts into the city, making a lot of pics, making blogs about it, discussing it later, because then you have all this material and then you must come up with innovative concepts from cool hunting to innovation. Here they are working. In a nice sideline, when the students, when in the rainy season, they all come with their umbrellas, and this is what the corridors look like. Donghua Yuan University working with. And that's our main source of information, all those blocks. And as you if you participate as a coolant, you have all those blocks as well. You can learn a lot. But at the same time, you also need interviews with the top experts from the field to give you more insights. And if you mix those, the interviews and all the raw material by the cool hunters, well, then you are unbeatable. And then, last but not least, we made a content analysis of Harvard Business Review, of The Economist, of Wired, of China Daily, of the New York Review of Books, and of the New York Times. And we read all the stuff they say we have to read. Of course, not all the stuff. But with these three things, the cool hunters, cool hunting, the top literature, and the top interviews, we are pretty, and you will be pretty unbeatable as well. So this is what you get when you consider, or where you actually participate in our masterclasses.